Hi, I'm Shabaana Khader from the University of Pittsburgh, and I'm here today to discuss our findings that will appear in a paper in the Journal of Clinical Investigation describing a role for CXCR5 positive T helper cells in protective immunity against tuberculosis. The purpose of the study is actually trying to define protective immune parameters that will help design better vaccines against tuberculosis. And this was performed as a collaborative effort between my lab here at the University of Pittsburgh and six other institutions that are located throughout the United States as well as in Mexico City. Tuberculosis is a global health problem. That means about one-third of the world's population is infected with the bacterium that causes the infection, which is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. The problem is, although 90 to 95% of the infected people do not have clinical symptoms, they present a latent form of the disease, which is called latent tuberculosis. Only 5 to 10% of the people who are infected will actually progress to forming this active form of the disease where they present the clinical symptoms. But the magnitude of the problem is that the latently infected people over their lifetime have a 10% risk of reactivating and progressing into active tuberculosis. And this risk goes up considerably if you're HIV infected, meaning your risk is now 10% per year of reactivating and progressing to active tuberculosis if you're HIV infected. So the key point there is that the CD4 T helper immune cells are required for protective immunity against tuberculosis. What was not known before, prior to our study, was that people knew that there were granulomas in the lung. But what they did not know is what is the difference between a protective granuloma that's found during latent TB and a non-protective granuloma that's found during active disease. So our study defines some of those immune parameters that show the difference between a protective granuloma and a granuloma that's not protective. And it shows an important role for this molecule, CXCR5, in forming those protective granulomas. And this molecule has to be expressed on the immune cell called the T helper cell for this entire protective effect to take place. We used human, non-human primate, as well as mouse models of infection to try to understand what constitutes this protective ectopic lymphoid tissue formation. In monkeys, we were able to identify that monkeys that were protected and had latent TB formed these ectopic lymphoid structures, whereas monkeys that have active clinical disease are unable to form these ectopic lymphoid tissues. And we used the mouse model to mechanistically address what was the molecule that was required to form these ectopic lymphoid structures. And we identified using a variety of different techniques, immunological as well as molecular, that it was this expression of the chemokine receptor CXCR5 on the T cells that was required to mediate formation of these structures. So mice that are deficient in CXCR5 are more susceptible to tuberculosis because they do not form these ectopic lymphoid structures. In fact, what we show also in the paper is that we can adoptively transfer T cells that express this receptor, and just the adoptive transfer of these cells is sufficient to rescue ectopic lymphoid structure formation, as well as susceptibility to tuberculosis can also be reversed in these mice. So our studies for the first time define not only that these ectopic lymphoid structures correlate with protection against tuberculosis, but have identified the molecular immune marker that mediates this protection by forming these ectopic lymphoid structures using the mouse model of tuberculosis. Obviously, tuberculosis is a global health problem, and we urgently need new diagnostics, and we need new improved vaccines to combat the disease. So what our studies really show is that not only can we use this marker perhaps as a diagnostic to differentiate between active and latent tuberculosis, but also perhaps use CXCR5 to target, to improve and make better vaccines so we can deliver the T cell to where the infected macrophages are to improve vaccine-induced immunity against tuberculosis.